Sure. Good morning, everybody. So yes, the objective of my presentation today is just to introduce rapidly who is Chromatotec and what is the strategy we can adopt for odor measurement. So I will show you an example at the final of my presentation, just to show you an example of realization in a wastewater plant. So about the company. So just Chromatotec, it's a French company. We manufacture analyzer. All our analyzer are GC-based. In fact, it's a gas chromatograph. So our objective is to quantify individually all the molecules, which could be VOC, sulfur, or ammonia analyzer, for example. And for odor measurement, what is very interesting for us is to combine correlation with to study correlation between an analytical solution with a standard methodology as olfactometry. The objective is not to introduce all the VOC analyzer because we have a lot of type of application, but here you have main markets. And just to show you about the repetition of production, Chromatotec is a French company, but in fact we export 90% of our activity worldwide. And so we are located in France, in Bordeaux, and we have subsidiaries in Houston, in Beijing, and we are represented in Canada by Westech, our partner. So about the solution provided, you can find here, it's an example. So it's an online monitoring system. So it's a complete solution with an analyzer, multiplexer to collect samples on several points to do analytical measurements. And the main advantage of this technology is to reach very low concentration. To differentiate the product we manufacture, in fact, Chromatotec provide online analyzer with very low concentration. When we say very low concentration, we have capability to reach sensitivity on VOC or sulfurs close to ppb and sometimes ppt levels. So we can reach and compare results for specific reference with the human nose odor perception, sorry. And what is very interesting for us is to provide validated results. So objective of our analyzer is to have automatic data, automatic results, but automatic validated results too. So it means that in all our equipment, we have an embedded calibration just to check the results and to be sure that when we predict results, it's not only an indicator, but a clear vision of the gas concentration for VOC or for sulfurs. So here it's a combined solution. And we can modular the type of detector, the type of injector, according to the molecules we want to target. And after, we can do a global fingerprint, and we establish global fingerprint correlation, chemical fingerprint correlation with sensory reference methodology, which could be dynamic olfactometry according to EN3725 or ISTM679. Here is some example of analyzer. If you want more details, we have a booth, so we will be able to discuss this point. But the only point here is to show you that we have capability to monitor individually all the VOCs. We can find all VOCs. VOCs, more than 129 VOCs we have on the ambient air. So these equipments are very interesting for ambient air applications. That's why we work with environmental agencies. But we can combine with the same configuration, sulfur analyzer. And the specificity of our equipment is to track individually each sulfur without interferences. So it's a very interesting solution when you want to have more information about total reduced sulfur or total sulfurs. You can have a total sulfur and individual concentration for sulfurs. And of course, we, when we have a specific application, we can integrate ammonia analyzer if we want to have more information on this. As I mentioned, results are very interesting and important for Chromatotec. That's why we have a small company. We are 50% in France, but we pass a lot of time to have validation for independent agency or independent organism. And according to each country, we develop each project to meet legislation requirements, as for example for the TUF in Germany, the GOST in Russia, USEP in US, and we have MCERT in Europe too, and certification too to work in hazardous area with ATEX certification. So about the several strategies, the objective is to be only to give you a brief introduction about analytical solution, because it's right that when we want to monitor odors, we can have a lot of type of application, a lot of strategy, and according to the focus expected, we can define a specific strategy. So some people, for example, works only with sensors. So in general, sensors are very specific to one molecules, and we located these sensors directly on site. Another one are more interested by global fingerprint. So someone use electronic noses. So main advantage is to have a continuous monitoring. After, the main issue is to have information about the gas composition. And you can have online gas chromatography, as we saw in the previous presentation. And our analytical solution are dedicated for online monitoring. And so we will provide the gas chromatograph, automatic gas chromatograph, just to separate each molecule you can have on the mixture. And when we consider odor at the source, you have, of course, dynamic olfactometry. So we speak about this item, so I will pass it rapidly. But it's very interesting, too, to associate dynamic olfactometry with measuring devices, just to check and to study the correlation between the two approaches, and to offer more information about the gas composition to help the user to understand what's happened directly on the process. Because it's right, it's very interesting to understand what is wrong when you have emission of odors, but the main objective in general is to reduce these odors. So of course you have odor control system, but the best information sometimes is to have a clear understanding of what happened directly on the process before solve the problem. And in the environments, some provider can provide the sensors, sensitive sensors. Again, here it's more indicator at this time, and you need one sensor for a specific molecules. And thanks to gas chromatograph, in fact, you can combine this approach as you have a global fingerprint, individual concentration for each molecules, and so it looks like you have multi-sensors with unique instruments. Other strategy to measure odors in the environment, we see it with previous presentation, is to provide odor mapping, to do some observatories using community odor assessments, and to use portable olfactometer. So in fact, we have integrated all these strategies in unique solution, which name is VG Odor, for vigilance of odors. And in fact, we associate according to the request of the user and the odor issue, several strategies by doing measurement at the source. And if we are interested by the odor impact of the site on the neighborhood, we associate dispersion monitoring software. And as we are very interested by automatic validation of our results, we associate embedded calibration in our analyzer. And when we are interested by odor impact of the site on the neighborhood, in this case, we associate neighborhood by a web platform where we collect automatically the complaints or the observation of the neighborhoods during a certain period. We adjust modeling software, and we provide alarms and warning directly at what happened directly on site to evaluate chemical impact and to help the user to understand what is wrong on the process. And when we have a look on the main challenge, we see it this morning, but we see that sometimes we don't take care about chemical analysis because it's very difficult to reach human nose sensitivities. And if we have a look directly with our analyzer, you will be able to check that we can reach for individual concentration, very low level of concentration, and level of concentration lower than the human nose for individual molecules. So thanks to this approach, we can obtain a complementary approach with a dynamic olfactometry and understand what happened directly on process when you have important odor concentration. And of course, as we provide analytical solution, the objective is to define correlation with reference method with a dynamic olfactometry and with perception of neighborhood when we are interested by odor impact of the site on the neighborhood. And the reason is just to have a reliable data and to manage automatically the process, because thanks to the observation and emission on the process, you can pilot or start or stop a process just to optimize the efficiency of your odor control system, thanks to a real data measurement with automatic validated results. So here it's an example of application which which is a VGO-DOR solution. So it's an all-in-one solution based in association of modular solution. It could be analyzer dispersion modeling software with a weather station, local weather station, and complaints management according to the request. So here it's automatic GC analyzer, which name is VG-INOS analyzer. It's the analytical device of the VGO-DOR solution. And we have capability to offer very sensitive results thanks to a patented solution for sulfur detectors based on the fact that this detector is very selective, no interference with VOCs, and so we can have a clear vision of what happened directly on sulfur. And in addition, we can integrate quantification of VOC to define a global fingerprint and to correlate with human nose. So here it's an example of integration and peripherals we can manage thanks to our system, because for example you can use only one system to pilot several points of collections. For example, when we have a lagoon, we can collect on several points of the site and do the analysis with unique solution using a multiplexer. And as I mentioned before, the particularity of our solution is to have an automatic calibration in the analyzer just to check results and to provide turnkey solution. And thanks to a web interface, you have results at a glance. So here it's an example of integration with a French company using dispersion modeling software. But our objective is not to sell a specific dispersion modeling software. We associate the dispersion modeling software according to the legislation, according to the performance and the topography of the site. So here it's an example of deployment in a wastewater plant, where we integrate a mixed solution with VOC, sulfur, dispersion modeling software, and complaints management. And we check the results for sulfur and VOCs. So here it's an example of chromatogram you can have directly with the analyzer. So you can see that you have a clear quantification of H2S, methylmercaptan, and DMS, DMDS. And so you can pilot this analyzer thanks to Modbus communication mode to have warning or alarm on each molecules and to give you information when you exceed a specific value on one of these compounds. And of course, you can have a total sulfur in parallel of this individual concentration. So here it's an example of what we can obtain with a reference bottle. And here it's what we have observed directly on site. So you see that in this case, we monitor H2S, SO2, methylmercaptan, and DMS at very low concentration. Here it's more or less on the ambience of the site, it was about 63 ppb for DMS and 60 ppb for H2S, close to the lagoon area. And we have an automatic data validation using DMS internal calibration tube just to check the results and to be sure that the reference is very stable and representative of what is emitted and measured by the equipment. So after, what is very interesting too is to use dispersion modeling software, as we mentioned before, and the main advantage of this technology is that you can have, as you see here, a map for a specific compound. Here it's an example for H2S. But as soon as we have defined correlation with dynamic olfactometry, you can obtain directly odor as a parameter just to evaluate odor impact of the site and to define on the virtual pond you are in green the odor impact and be alert or be warned when you exceed a specific value on site or on the neighborhood. So you have a SMS when you exceed a specific value and the pond goes from green to orange or red. And after, what is very interesting is to evaluate odor impact to be warned by the chemical impact. But the other point is to understand what is the origin of the odor. And so, thanks to this web interface, for example, using a specific mathematical model, which could be Gaussian, Lagrangian, according to the topography and the complexity of the site, we can have a contribution area here, and you can have information saying, okay, the odor perceived by the neighborhood at 8 o'clock come with a high probability of, and we need to define this probability, come from the lagoon, from the biofilter, by the scrubber. So it's a nice tool to facilitate the understanding of what happened directly on site, because as we see before, it's a lot of time to understand what is wrong when you have odor issues. And here, it's an example of integration with a TOMS interface, where here it's the main advantage is to couple directly dispersion modeling software with complaints management. And so it's very interesting in this case, because automatically you collect the perception of neighborhood by sensory evaluation, and we adjust, in fact, the results using dispersion modeling software, and we offer a dynamic concentration of what happened directly on site, and we inform the user when he exceeds level, and we inform the user when where is the origin of the contamination observed, for example, on a specific point. So it's a global solution. As I mentioned, it's a modular solution just to understand what happened directly on site and to provide real data measurement on site. So it's an example here of a trend you can have on site. It's a trend for VOCs, for sulfurs, sorry. So you can see if we zoom on it, that here the concentration observed on the atmosphere, it's at ppb level, so it's very low or at this level. And if we compare with literature, when we have a look, for example, or individual concentration for each sulfur, you can see that here it's a perception of human nose. We are close to ppb levels. So thanks to the type of analyzer, we can individually understand and quantify the concentration for odorants on the process or on the atmosphere. So here it's an example for VOC for sulfurs, and here it's an example for VOC. Thanks to the analyzer integrated, we can monitor C2 to C6, C6 to C12, or up to C12 to, for example, C20, and have individual concentration. So it's some example of chromatogram. And for each peak, you have a capability, thanks to Modbus communication mode, to be warned when you exceed specific value, and to help you to reduce odor at the origin by acting directly on the process. So it's an example for light molecules, example for EV molecules, and again, if we have a look on light or medium volatility of molecules, we can see that the level of concentration measured by the human nose is close to 1,000 ppb, and our equipment are able to reach today ppb, ppt, and recently ppq level, using a trap embedded on our equipment, and every time with auto-validated results, thanks to internal calibration integrated on our equipment. So here it's a slide to summarize the methodology. In fact, we have a global fingerprint with VOCs, another one with the sulfurs, so we can treat this chromatogram as a global fingerprint or individual concentration for each odorant. And after we establish correlation based on dynamic olfactometry, or for example, when we want to evaluate what happened directly on site with a portable olfactometer, like the one discussed this morning, the SM100, which is able to qualify the odor concentration directly on site and compare results provided by our analyzer on a specific point with a perception of sensory evaluation. Or the other solution is to collect Taylor bags on several points and to do analysis on the laboratory using European or American standards, and to do correlation with instrumental analytical solution and sensory evaluation. So just to finalize about VigiOdor. So VigiOdor, it's a solution developed to manage measurement units with alert and warning. Initially, the solution was dedicated for VOCs and sulfurs. And as we can reach very low concentration, we have studied correlation with dynamic olfactometry. And in wastewater plants, actually, we have obtained a very good correlation in terms of EN3725. So we go on other type of application for landfill site, because it's more complex, but in wastewater plant, as we have a lot of sulfurs and our equipment is very dedicated for sulfur quantification and VOC, we can have a good correlation between these two type of solution. And what is very important for us is to have a reliable and objective data. And we know that when we are on other issue, it's very important to facilitate communication with neighborhood, with authorities, and so we need to have a reliable results. And thanks to the quantification of odorants, it's very interesting to have accurate information, just to have another tool in addition to dynamic olfactometry, dispersion modeling software, to understand what happened directly on site and to try to reduce odors. So, yes, I invite you to visit our booth. Maybe as the time is running, I will finalize just to say that our equipment is unique in terms of sulfur quantification. Actually, in terms of quantification, we are alone to produce equipment able to reach PPQ level for sulfurs. We pass a lot of time, as I mentioned before, for certification and auto-validation of data. So thank you for your attention. And as mentioned, we are on the booth, close to the Westech booth, which is our partner in Canada. Thank you.
What role does the nose of human beings who are traveling through a neighborhood play as opposed to the kind of technology that you put in place?
We consider that our technology is not the unique technology for odor measurement. Of course, we need the human nose as a reference because it's the truth. The human nose is the truth, and when people are exposed to the odor, you can say, here are the results. And this is the truth. That's why we need to develop several strategies to provide a complete solution. And we know that the main issue when we want to do odor measurement, and we know using dynamic olfactometry, is to have a representative results with a very low uncertainty of measurement. And in addition to this methodology, the use of chemical, the odorant chemicals, helps to define this this gas composition and this mixture of odors. And it's why that on the past, it was very difficult to reach very low concentration. That's why a lot of study have already been done, saying we cannot reach human sensitivity. And our objective is to show you that today, with a VOC analyzer, with sulfur analyzer, we have capability to reach very low concentration, better than the human nose, if we consider individual concentration. After, the main challenge, of course, is to see if the chemical concentration for individual molecules can be correlated with the human nose. And today, we have results, positive results, in wastewater plant, and we go on more and more application just to check if we can have a global fingerprint for other type of application.
Okay. Well, thank you very much.
Welcome.